Hello everyone, welcome to this another video where we learn how to make a mind map using Coggle. In our last video, we learned MindMaster, which was a software to make the mind maps. Now Coggle is also a similar software which can be used for making of mind map, but there are certain differences which you can explore and you can see which one suits your requirements. So let us get started. For that, type in your browser Coggle. So this website, that is coggle.it, would open. If you are using it for the first time, you need to sign up. As I have already signed up, so I'll simply log in and my Coggle page would open. Now if I want to start creating a diagram, I'll have to click on this create diagram, and this is the main title which Coggle wants me to enter, and around this my whole mind map would be based. Now I want to add three branches to this, which is life, general and reinsurance, right? So this is life, general and reinsurance. You can have as many branches as you want. So you saw how we add branches. We just click on this plus sign and we'll have the branches. If you want to undo any action, just press Ctrl Z. Now I want that there should be some border or outside, there should be something around this on the life. So I'll right click on this and I'll get this circle. In this circle we have various things. The important thing is this thing which is here, a diamond. So I'll click on this. It is for the choose shape. So I can choose any shape which I want for my this particular thing. And these are, some things are free and some things are subscribed. So this, I'll use this which is free. Similarly, I'll use here reinsurance and I'll right click and I'll use again the same thing. And for the general also, I'll do the same. Now if I want to have the branches, after having this I can have the branches for life also. I want to have four branches suppose. So I'll click here term, I'll click here endowment, I'll click here ULIP, I'll click here money back, and I want to have one more. So I'll click here whole life. Just a second. So I'll click here whole life. So this is the first thing. Now if I want to change the color, that is also allowed, but that is in the subscribe thing. You can see as soon as I click here and select anything, this box opens which shows that I need to upgrade. So I won't be going for this. Similarly, in case of general also, we can have further branches, and I'll just Control Z. And I'll drag my whole this thing here on the top, and then I'll have the branches, right? So you can have various branches and you can drag the branches, right? So let me write marine, health, travel, and let me have one more. Let us have travel, right? So this is how we can have various branches. Now if I want to change the size of any of the box, I can simply do like this, right? So it will change the font size. You can also change the font size for this, right? So we can change the font size for any of the things. Alright, now if I want, there are three things that can be done. Let me click here, and these are the three things that can be added. I can add a link to a website in this particular branch, I can add an image, and I can also add an icon. Let us start with the icon. In icon, I'll click this. So what I'll see is this icon is here. Similarly in insurance, let me click on a particular link. Now for link, I need to go to YouTube, and on YouTube I have to be very particular that I am using the website which is allowed under Creative Commons license. So I'll go to filter, I'll go to Creative Commons, and from there I'll choose, let me take this. Alright, so I'll take the link from here, I'll copy it and I'll go back to Coggle and I'll paste it here. So what happens is, as soon as you click here on insurance now, I would be redirected to this particular website. So you can give additional information to your students via these links. Alright, so let us try with an image. I'll click on reinsurance. Let me click on this because I have the image for general insurance, and it asked me to upload any image. So I add this image over here and it will resize the image as is required by Coggle. You can see here your image was resized and this is how my image would appear. Right. So this is the basic chart that you can make. You can also change how the chart appears and we can also download it. Now let us see, we can share this Coggle. Here are two options, whether you want to share it with the public so that anybody who logs into Coggle, he or she can view this particular chart. You can simply double click this and you will have this. Right, you have used all your private diagrams, so I have to allow this because I have been doing this for quite long. I'll click on this embed and this is the embedded code which can be transferred to any of the LMS and there the students can view this particular Coggle chart. If I want to share this, then this is the link. In front of this you have this option, right? If I don't click this, it means that the viewers may create their own copies. They can take this particular template and they can create their own copies. If I don't want that to happen, I can simply do this. So viewers cannot create the copies. I'll click the link and I can send it to anyone via the WhatsApp. The other option is I can download this using this icon. So I can download this. I can download it in the form of a PDF as an image. So I'll download it as a PDF. And this is how it will appear. And it can be shared with the students. Alright, so now let us see and go back to our Coggle and see what happens in the gallery. These are the options in the gallery. Now it shows that we can also use these charts, these templates are there, some of them are free, so we can use them and we can just modify it and make our this mind map. So you can see this, this is an example, 5 forms of the business ownership. Right, so you can also use these and all the mind maps that I have created would be saved in this created by you folder. So all the mind maps you can see that I have created are saved here. If you want to delete this, you simply go on these 3 dots and you can delete that particular chart. All right, and we can also create a new folder. So suppose I have 10 chapters that I want to teach my students and I want to create mind map for each of them. So I'll simply create a folder, I'll give it a name and I go to created by you and I'll drag my mind maps to that particular folder. So you can see now my diagram that I have just created is now in my life insurance folder and it is no more in created by you. So this is how you can organize all your mind maps that you have created. I hope that you enjoyed this session with us. Thank you so much.